In the last section, we were working with loops, and for our last example, we were attempting to do a for in loop on a tag set, and it threw some errors. So I wanted to take that as an example to introduce you to the Chrome debugger that'll help us find out what's going on with this script and what we can do, if anything, to fix it. Previously, we had used a for in example on the screen items, and we basically followed that same syntax for our tag set. So for let I in my tagset.items, and then we are just printing out the name and the value and incrementing the value. So let's take this to runtime and see kind of what we're getting. Okay, if we run the script, I've got a try catch block and it has problems with me accessing the property called items. So let's go take a look again at the definition of the tag set item in the help section. So in the engineering software, we'll go to show help and visualizing processes, RT Unified, programming scripts, WinCC Unified object model. And then under objects, we'll go to the tags area and the tag set object. Now under tag set, if we go to methods, notice that there is an item, but not an items. So it's a difference in nomenclature from, say, screen.items. There is no S. So obviously that's one of our problems. So let's go back to our script and we'll take the S off here and we'll save and go to runtime. So now if we run the script, we get a different error and it says cannot read property name of undefined. So looking back at the script, so it's failing right here. It's trying to get the name of our index number in the tag set. The debugger is really going to help us see what's going on. So let's set up our debugger and then run the script and see what we have. First, if you refer back to the references, there was a reference document on the Siemens website, how to use the Chrome debugger. So going to that link, it tells you that the runtime manager is installed, you've got to have administrator rights, and you have to have the Google Chrome browser. They do have a list of items you need to check, and this first set of items tells you that you have to go to your runtime manager and turn on your debugger. So this is the first thing that we're going to do. So we'll open our SIMATIC runtime manager, and if you recall, we need to open it in run as administrator. And you'll click on your runtime project and then hit settings. And we'll go to the script debugger and we have to check our screen debugger. We'll click OK and then the instructions say you have to reset runtime in order for this to take effect. So I'm going to stop runtime and then restart it. Next, we need to find out which version of Chrome we have because they make a distinction between versions less than 80 and greater than 80. So all you have to do is go to Chrome:// version. And I have version 92. That's well above 80. So these are the instructions that I'll be using. It tells you to start the script debugger by calling the address Chrome:// inspect. And so here's my advice. First, you need to be in runtime, and it's helpful to go ahead and go to the page in runtime that you want to debug the scripts on. Then you can open another tab and open your link. And when you first get here, you're not going to see anything, but you need to wait probably about a minute because it's loading what you call the network targets. So after a few moments, you'll see that we have a VCS1 dynamic, and then here it's looking at our JavaScripting page. And so if you hit inspect on that, it's going to open up your developer windows. And when you expand here, this shows you everything that we have open. We've got our global modules. We've got our main screen, and we only have one script on our main screen that's populating our current picture name. There's a function list for our main screen. And then finally, we have the event context of our JavaScript. These are all the scripts that we've created. Notice that we have our definitions area, and everything is compiled as one big script on your events context as it is on your properties context. So there's all of our shape scripts and things like that. So if we go to the bottom, we can find our button 19 where we did our for in loop on the tag set item. We can put a breakpoint there to kind of see what's going on. And so you can put a breakpoint anywhere just by clicking near the line number. And when that script executes, it will stop here. And then we can use controls that are located up here to kind of step through the code and see what each item is. So with this up, I'll go back and I will run the loop. And it automatically brings me here and we get some information about the variables. So you can see my tag set array, which was created up here. I can mouse over that and it'll show me the entire array. It'll show me what the ordinals are. Or you can look here in your block and it will show you the same thing. And if I mouse over, say, item.name, it'll tell me the value of that. So here we are in the loop. And if we mouse over I, right now it's undefined because we have not executed the let I. And so we have several controls up here. This is the step over. And I know my cursor's in the way, but that's the only way I can show it. So we got step over, we've got step into, we got step out of, and we've just got step. So I'll hit step, and then now if I mouse over and click on I, it's going to show me that it's zero. But notice something here. It is not the number zero, it is the character zero. And so that is why we have this number cast right here, is it is casting that string zero into the number zero. Now I want you to think about what we're looking at and think about our last lesson. Do you see the problem yet? Well, the problem is that I is a zero and not a one. If you recall in the tag set always enumerated from one and not zero. And so that is why it is not able to get the name of the zeroth member, because there is no zeroth member. And we can't really change the code right here in the debugger. We're going to have to go change it back on the JavaScript page on the button. So we'll pull up the software. Now we could just add a one to everywhere this is used, but it might be easier to just create a variable and say let index equal number I, because we have to cast it from a string, right? And then plus one. And then we'll just copy index and paste it in everywhere that we're using it. And then we only have to change it in one place. So let's save this and check it out in runtime. So when we're in runtime, I'm not yet going to go to the JavaScript screen. Instead, I'll go to the inspect page and refresh it. Every time you go back to runtime or you change which screen is showing, you need to go back to your inspect page and refresh so it can pick up the scripts in order to debug them. Now notice that we have a JavaScript event script running as well as the main, but JavaScript page has not been up yet, and that's because we left a breakpoint up. So we can go to that, and there's a clear breakpoints there. And if we clear our breakpoints and then refresh our page, then we no longer have the JavaScript, and that was an invalid script anyway. So another tip is when you close the debugger, always clear your breakpoints so that you don't get that to happen. Then we'll navigate to our JavaScript page, and again, we'll need to refresh so that it can load that network target. And we'll just go to inspect, and we'll just put a breakpoint here at the same place, and we'll run our script. So we'll go right to the breakpoint, and we're just going to do a step, and we'll do that step twice. And so now index is a one. And then as we step through this, and notice that when I step through, it's going directly to my debug statement and it's printing out our source, which is button 19, and our message, which is the value for value 1. So that tells you that we're actually pretty good. So I'm just going to hit resume, and it's just going to resume back to the next breakpoint. And if I were to step through this a couple of times, you can see that we've gone to value 2. So at this point, I'm going to get rid of the breakpoint and then hit my resume execution button. And we can see that our script is now working. If I put our debug window up, and you can see it's working exactly. So we've been able to use our debugger to kind of get some insight into what our variables and what our arrays are doing, and it allows us to kind of think through the problem. Okay, so now I have an assignment for you. This assignment will familiarize you with debugging scripts in the Chrome browser. What I would like you to do is first go to the resources for this chapter and go to the How to Use the Chrome Debugger link on the Siemens site. And of course, you'll have to enable debugging in the SIMATIC Runtime Manager, figure out your Chrome version, and based on your version, learn how to start the debugger. Once you have that set up, add a button to your JavaScripting screen and copy the script code from the class resources. It'll say debug tag set for in loop script.txtfile. And that is the original script with a few changes that needs to be debugged. Then go to runtime and navigate to your debugger, and then open your JavaScript page event context and use the debugger to find and correct the issues. So add some breakpoints in the loop and different areas of the script, inspect your variables, and find out what's wrong with it. And continue to identify and correct these issues until the code runs correctly.